Mashlumcha, Mashlumme. I have a question. Wouldn't you want to know how to get a car loan without a social security number if that was actually possible? Would you or would you not? Would you like to know the statutes, the codes, the acts to give to a bank showing and proving that you do not need to give them a social security number to open up a bank account? If you answer yes to both of these questions, keep watching this video. Hit the like button. Subscribe if you're not already subscribed to the channel. And more importantly, click the notification button if you're already subscribed so that you'll actually get the notification to essentially important videos such as this one. And be certain to share this all over social media. And to those of you that don't donate for the cause, shame on you. Those leeches to society. And those of you that have donated, and those of you that do give the thumbs up without being asked, you'll really appreciate it. I appreciate that. And I reciprocate that energy by giving you videos like this and testimonies like this. If you answer yes to both of these questions, keep watching this video. I just want to drop some right knowledge to let you guys know, family, about a recent small victory that your good brother Tazadaq Shah, the deprogram enlightener, had in regards to the no social security number corner. I know you want to hear this important video. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Can I ask you a question? Wouldn't you want to learn how I, Tazadaq, obtained a perfect credit score and was able to walk into a Mercedes Benz dealership and walk out with an S550 Benz, no money down, in 20 minutes? Is that something that you would actually like to be able to do also? If you keep listening to this video and do what I've done and emulate my lifestyle, believe it or not, you could do it. That's a $120,000 car. That's how we own it.
So I want to say this to you. For all of you that think that, you know, this whole secure party credited thing is a fraud, I don't brag or boast, but I'm just want to show and prove something, right? So yesterday, I'm going to tell you what, like, I got a perfect credit score. To all of you that think that this is a fraud and all of that, right now I'm sitting in a brand new Benz. I don't do 2019, but I walked into the Mercedes-Benz dealership and they try to give me a 2019 Benz with no money down. Now, if you think just anyone could do that, why don't you go and try it sometime, right? So I settled for the 2017 because the vehicle depreciates as soon as you leave the lot. But my point being, if you just go back a few years ago, my credit score was only 550. Now I have a perfect credit score. And you can learn this too. Let me show you I'm not lying.
Shalom. It's Tazadaq, right? For all of you that think the secure party creditor thing is really a joke, right? So what you're looking at right now is a 2017 Benz. And the only reason I didn't get the 2019 is because the vehicle depreciates too quick when you buy a new vehicle. For those of you who don't know the game, I'm going to give you the game. So right now what you're looking at is my new Benz, right? And I'm talking S series. This is an S550 right here. S550 right here. I'm talking about $129,000 vehicle. How many people that you knew or know, for that matter, that could actually walk into credit, you know what I mean, a Mercedes-Benz dealership, I'm gonna let you have a look inside right here, and then just get offered a $129,000 vehicle with no money down? You see what I'm saying? I'm not bragging or boasting. I'm just showing you that the secure party creditor stuff really does work. And I'm not test driving this, and neither am I bragging or boasting. So you see the features. I mean, this vehicle has crazy, you know, things on it that it's just like, you know, kind of like unbelievable that, you know, they could do this to a vehicle. I'm not bragging or boasting. I'm not really about that. But I just want to show people that Tazadaq is real. So, yeah, you're looking at the Benz. I just copped this yesterday. No money down, by the way. $129,000 vehicle, no money down.
You see what it is. I'm talking S series, top of the line Benz. I'm not bragging or boasting, just trying to show you folks that, hey, I came from the bottom. And if I could do this, you could do it too. I came from the bottom. You go back a few years ago, my credit score was 550. Now I have a perfect credit score. And I'm going to be doing a seminar like coming up real quick, real soon, to show you how to actually perfect your credit score. And you could do this. And you could walk into a Mercedes Benz dealership, Porsche, if you get your credit score like mine, and you actually apply what you believe, you could do the same thing. It's nothing special about me, but I'm telling you this, right? Ain't nothing about me made up, homie. Tazadaq, you know who said it. That's how we
If you can't own. Do anything else, at least admit that I'm real. There's nothing about me made up, homie. Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
And so the next thing I'm going to take you over to is my all-black range. All-black Benz, all-black black range. This is not bragging. This is not boasting. But it's showing you that what you call a little Negro from the hood that they told was actually going to be nothing, that they say was destined to fail to be whatever he wants to be. This is God's work. This is not mine. This is not bragging or boasting, but I'm that dude that's inspiration for all of you out there that they told they can't be nothing. You see, you understand what I'm saying? When I walked into the Benz dealership, I didn't go and try and impress nobody because I know who I am. I went right after the gym all sweaty and wet and all of that. So at first they act like they really didn't want to help me until Doc manifest himself. You understand what I'm saying? So you could do the same thing. There's nothing special about me. It's the drive. It's the indomitable spirit. And it's the belief that you could accomplish whatever you strive to accomplish. That's what it is. Tazadaq, God's work. It's how we own it. I'm going to take you a quick glimpse of the range right here. You can see nothing about me is made up. At the car wash right now, just watching it work. As you see, I mean, this is the range right here. You see my Benz, and this is the range. And this is actually what being a secure party creditor could do. Like, you could do it also. It's not just like I'm bragging, but a lot of people think that I'm making things up. As you can see, this is not no old vehicle or anything like that. Again, this is a sport. It's all based on what you believe. You know what I mean? If you believe that you can achieve it, then you can do it. If you don't, it's never going to happen. And so that's what it is, king, queen. You can have, be, do, whatever it is that you believe. If you don't believe, you can't perceive it to be true, then it's not going to happen. Tazadaq, you know, said it. This is how we own it. So yeah, as you see, I'm standing right in front of my range. And this one right here has been settled and closed. You understand what I'm saying? To those of you that are out there that understand what I'm saying, then great. If you don't, then go and check it out.
For most, giving all praises to the God of our forefathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, whose proper name is Yahweh. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, go ahead and seek yourself a competent counsel. Then please be advised. Everything I'm about to give you is strictly for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. Not to be taken as legal advice, nor am I suggesting anyone do any of this. And again, for any of this stuff to be effective, go to my website, become a secure party creditor now, order my books and DVDs, so you'll learn how to speak this language and be able to stand effectively as a creditor. Do it now. Do not delay. Stop hesitating because it's keeping you stagnated. Now, I recently tried to open a bank account with a local bank, right? Few days ago, and when they asked for the social security number, I informed them that I didn't have one. They utterly refused and said that the social security number was essentially important, and that without a social security number, that they absolutely could not open an account of any kind. Now, this was the first line person, the teller at the window, and they went and got a supervisor, and I suppose they was actually supposed to have supervision. They didn't have that supervision. So then I proceeded to enlighten them, as I am the deprogram enlightener. First, I had to deprogram the cognitive dissonance that they was actually under. Then I proceeded to enlighten them that they were actually, in fact, wrong. So the first thing I did was inform them that I had actually terminated the Social Security number legally in accordance with 20 CFR 3A7 404.1905. I don't want you to believe anything that I'm saying. Go and look it up for yourself. This is very valuable, valuable information. You can take it or let it alone, and you can like it, understand it, believe it or not. If you got to give me one thing, you got to give me that I am real. I'm one of the last real Kahans left. Real priests teaching the Lord now. So the next thing, I just informed them that the bank could not be held legally responsible for anyone failing to obtain a Social Security number and failing to obtain a Social Security number from me personally, pursuant to 31 CFR 103.34A1. And the third thing I brought out was I informed them that under the Internal Revenue Code itself, Section 6041, that they, the bank, were not required to provide any taxpayer identification number on the Form 1099 that they file with the IRS at the end of the year. I also informed them that pursuant to 26 CFR 301.6109 1C, that they were under no obligation to obtain a Social Security number from me. And point five, I informed them that 42 USC, and should be writing these down, 42 USC 404 essentially actually makes it a felony to use threat, to use duress, or coercion to try to force a man or woman by fear or deceit to provide his given Social Security number in an unlawful manner. What am I giving you, family? I'm giving you the law. I'm giving you the law. Now, you could take it a lot alone. I'm not here to convince you whether this works, but you've seen the Mercedes Benz. You see the Range Rover. You decide for yourself, because no matter what I show you, I've had people come on and give testimony after testimony because you're in such a debtor mind state and that fear just overwhelms you. You just can't think straight. You can't see straight, so you stay stuck. So decide for yourselves. So after a brief meeting with the controller and legal counsel of the bank, I received a phone call stating that I would actually be allowed to open the account. And so then within 20 minutes, good brothers, sisters, I got approved for a loan. So the only thing I'm going to ask of you is to click the like button, share, subscribe, click the notification bell. And if you want to become a secure party creditor, I urge you to study, get my books and DVDs. There is a way out. I wasn't supposed to be here. Do you understand? I was just what they refer to as a little nigga from the damn ghetto, man. I wasn't supposed to be here where I came from. I wasn't supposed to be here. The teachers told me I was most likely not to succeed. My own damn mom told me you ain't gonna be a damn thing just like her father. I wasn't supposed to be here. You don't understand why this is such a big deal. Said Tazadaq, plenty of people got bent. Check this out, homie. I came from the bottom. So I'm telling you where you are right now, you cannot allow that to define you. Don't let people place limitations on you. Because ultimately, at the end of the day, if you allow someone to limit you, what you're doing is you're saying that their perception of you, their perspective of you, their view of you is more important than that of your own, which makes you weak. Weak. So it's time to strengthen up. It's time to gird up your loins. It's time to go in war mode. This is an ideological war. Do you understand? And these people cannot be punished really in their court. They have diplomatic immunity. They have sovereign immunity. So they have to be punished in international courts when you get violated. You are actually set up to be a trust when you're using that social security number. When you're using that social security number, you have no country. You're a member of a state, which is a franchisee of Washington, D.C. You could take it and let it alone. I keep saying this. I've been saying this for years. Some of you, you'd be ready to accept it. And then a debtor comes along because your faith was rooted on stony ground and you stop believing. Then you go and look for someone else. You're running from channel to channel. Well, I'm getting results over here. You see how I'm rolling, man. Top of the line, S-class. Not bragging and boasting, but I wasn't supposed to be. I ain't pushing nothing illegal. This is knowledge. I'm giving you right knowledge. What else will it take? What the hell will it take to wake you people up? So can you please pass this video on to listeners in hopes that it may help someone else that may find themselves in this situation? My name is Tazadaq Shah Bey, the Deprogram Enlightener. I'm trying to deprogram you because you're definitely being enlightened. This is right knowledge. This is God's work. It's how we own it. Peace. Two fingers. To all of the debtor haters that keep hating, I'm just going to keep waving two fingers in the air. Peace. And so I'm going to just give you more of what you hating on, which is right knowledge, which is truth and results. And you hate me right now. You debtors hate me right now because you're saying, how the hell did this Negro do this? It's God's work. It's not mine. That's how I did it. So with that, I'm going to say shalom. Peace, shalom. Tazadaq, you know, set.